Ready myself.
I got you. What do you want? Another one.
Exactly, man. You are right, brother.
Dam unblocked, the voracious Dreki dead. I'd say this jungle is well on its way back to its original glory.
Tell me, any progress on finding my body and the other half of my stuff?
like our good deed has already gone back to wildlife. Suppose I spoke too soon.
Dragon's perched on that structure. Should we find a way up?
Wait.
What is it you want?
Are you a father?
Yes.
Then you must understand. My son, this toy, it was for him. But now he's gone. That day, so much chaos and death. I was panicked. Looking for my son. Please, help reunite me with my son and Folkfanger.
We're gonna help him, right?
What is the last thing you saw, Spirit?
Statues. Two of them. Dragons facing away from each other. Separated like my son. This toy. It will bring me back to him.
This story is like many in this valley. Separated from someone they love by death.
We gotta get him back to his son.
You do? Huh? I assumed you'd say something like, reuniting the dead is pointless.
Not this time.
off.
Alka.
Ah, a hunter lives here.
A careless one.
How's that?
We found its home.
Remember to ask Tyr about his travels to the lands beyond the seas.
You wish to travel the world?
I don't know. Maybe. See new places. Find out more about myself. This is itchy. I think my beard's coming in.
Is it?
Yeah, on my jawline. See? It's growing.
Is it?
Well, that's not just dirt.
It's not dirt. Thank you.
If we keep going this way, I believe we'll reach that near Dragon's Lair.
Yes.
Just making sure you know where you're going.
Thank you.
I have to get past those vines somehow.
Trying to bludgeon us.
Then we must get closer.
Hmm? down!
Mimir, how did they capture Garm in the first place?
That was Tyr's doing. He lured the beast somewhere safe and kept it distracted by lending his own arm to be gently chewed. Once the chains were on and the gate to Helheim was open, Garm bit Tyr's arm clean off in retribution.
But Tyr's not missing an arm.
Well, it grew back, eventually. He is a very resourceful god, after all.
Something must be casting a spell on it. Behind you, brother!
Hey, Emir. Ever heard of the Utengard?
The Utengard? Yes. It was a Jotnar concept. The giants believed that even though Odin destroyed Emir's body, the first giant never ceased to dream, even after death. They believed Emir's dreams would endure forever. I think they found some measure of comfort in the idea, as do I, that though Odin may take your body, he will never have all of you. Why, lad? Where do you see that word?
Can't remember. Saw it somewhere once and it stuck with me.
It's a good word.
The nest, brother, the nest!
It's calling more wind! That did it!
Go on, brother!
Out them!
Move!
How's the shield holding up, lad?
It's good. I always knew Sindri was a great blacksmith, but this magical shield, it just feels natural.
The shield is well made, but it is you who wields it with skill.
Thanks. Much further, we'll be right on top of the ogre. Better be sure we're ready.
We fight!
Yeah! I got that! Stay quiet!
It was ours, you opportunistic sod.
It went back to its perch. Let's go after it.
That's another raven sent to the Tree of the Dead. Perhaps we should check up on it, hmm?
Thank you. I can't wait to see his face again. I'll give him this gift and tell him about the brave people who helped me.
Now you can help us. What did you see that day?
I was at the mead hall. Thor was there. He had a strange drinking companion. Some sort of creature, the likes of which I'd never seen. It had this barrel of mead that seemed to never go empty.
What were they doing?
Getting blind drunk from the looks of it. They were passing drinks around, reveling. Everyone had a temple too many, but Thor, he was by far the drunkest of any man there that day.
Mimir, what do you make of this?
Thor has always loved a strong drink with questionable company. I've never heard any word of his creature companion. This isn't a lot to go on, I'm afraid.
Well, we know one thing. Thor was totally drunk when the valley was destroyed.
There's still nothing to find out. And whether your mother was involved remains unclear.
You can yell at me, if you want. I'll leave it.
What would that accomplish?
Might make you feel better.
No. You didn't trust me enough to talk through your worries. That's a wound not easily mended.
I'm sorry.
You needn't be. The fault is mine.
Now you can open that gate without that ogre hurling detritus at us.
Father, what was Spartan training like?
Unforgiving.
Is that why you didn't train me like one? Did you not think I could handle it?
I did not think you should have had to.
Thanks.
Spring. Time of rebirth. Renewal.
Oh, I've missed the smell of those flowers. I'm sorry, kid. Just come back already.
Hmm.
Look at that. Fancy a dip, brother?
What was that? Did the lake just react to us destroying that crystal?
It will appear.
The lands of Vanaheim are certainly more alive than those in other realms. Perhaps it's glad you got rid of that crystal.
Seems like the pond still wants something. What if you threw a crystal in? Whoa, it worked! Look, it gave us a gift in return. Oh wow, that equipment will prove useful. And crystal shards. I bet we'll get a reward for any we return to the pond.
That's handy. Good thing we collected all those crystals in the first place, eh? Another crystal for the pond. That's the last of the missing schematics. I suspect you've got some new sword hilts in your future. Thank you.
tell you. I read something in Odin's library about what Gjallarhorn is supposed to do. If blown by a god, it sounds through all the realms and harmonizes the space between them. Blow it somewhere like Tyr's temple, and it would be like opening up all the realm travel towers at once.
It's quite a vulnerability. Wonder why he didn't just destroy it.
Some artifacts defy destruction.
Well, we should make Freya aware of this.
You! Come with the child! Things to do.
You were right to summon me. We must talk.
As you ask.
This one has a strong personality. Good
Speak.
Thing I've got... The tree has become rather overgrown.
And?
And if it grows too wildly, the branches risk getting too heavy and falling, which is not ideal considering they hold all the realms.
I am no gardener.
What an absolute shock. No, I do not require any horticultural skills from you, but I would ask that you keep an eye open for the stags of the four seasons. They normally graze upon the tree and keep it tidy. Unfortunately, Bitter decided it would be funny to trick Arrogant into releasing them. If you happen to find the stags during your travels, I would greatly appreciate assistance in bringing them home. I would have one of my spectral squirrels do it, but they, well, keep eating the feed I give them. Consequence of it being the most delicious food in all the Nine Realms, I suppose.
We have seen these stags.
Great! Then all you need is some feed. Once you've found a stag, the feed should calm them down. Then one of my spectrals will guide them back here. And, don't eat the feed, please.
I will not.
Vigenis asked me if I was too chicken to release them, but I am in fact not chicken-like whatsoever. So as you can see, I have no choice.
Yes, of course.
Farewell.
Any luck finding those lean worms?
I was hoping we'd visit the crater again.
There's work to be done. See, the warriors still haunt the crater. We could put them to rest. And what else? I strongly suspect there are more spirits who witnessed the clash that destroyed their home.
Works for me. Definitely need that.
Wait, feels like there was something else. Ready when you are.